All right, well, yeah, this hand is, has real cards in it, unlike game one, where not very many real cards. All right, so turn one, I get to play scry land, unless I draw soldier. Soldier would be good. I'm gonna keep the land. My hand is pretty mana intensive, so I think I'd rather keep it. I'm gonna play a turn two sovereign, turn three Zathar Necromancer, and then next turn Underworld Connections, which I think is actually a nice little curve. I can take a million damage off my lands, but that is acceptable. So I get to attack with Imposing Sovereign. If my opponent has Azorius Charm, then that is fine. No reason to play Zathar Necromancer first. I'm gonna play it now though, and hope for no counterspells. I would have played Ghost Council earlier against my opponent previously had I known he was playing Esper, but I wasn't 100% sure. Just cracking that Elixir, not a play I generally like to make. All right. I'm fine with a Wrath, less fine with a Jace. Jace is mildly annoying. But I still get to attack into it, and I get to play Underworld Connections. Let's play it on a Swamp here. Draw a card. See if we hit anything sweet. Alright, let's just attack Jace. I just can't just sit here doing nothing, and then I get to play Obsidian at some point, and I'm kind of going off with connections. And once I hit like negates and thought seizes, I can actually start doing things. And so Jace goes down to three. Pretty immune to Wrath. Blood Baron at this point would be annoying. It does come into play tapped. That is a positive. All right, minusing Jace. All right, well it's gonna be Revelation or nothing. One could take Land Elixir, I suppose. Yeah. And playing a Blood Baron? Alright, well, comes to play tapped, I get to eat Jace. Wouldn't mind a Far and Away here, but I think I'd rather play Obsidian just so I can get a giant clock on the board. And let's attack Jace and attack my opponent. Alright, so I'm at 17, opponent's at 17, Obsidian's coming in. I've got a whip, which kind of helps the race too. I don't mind taking damage, and I'm attacking back for a lot more. Plus, I have Underworld Connections just sitting there waiting to extract value. Alright, so no attacks, unsurprisingly. Just draw a card, then draw. Probably just draw another card first. There aren't too many things I could draw that would make me want to do something different. Alright, let's cast Thoughtseize here, just to see what we're up against. Elixir plus X is the plan. So didn't cast Dissolve. Interesting. Rev Elixir. Clearly don't care about Devour Flesh. I think I'm just going to take one of the Revelations. And then cast a Cartel Aristocrat. And play a Watery Grave. I would be pretty happy if my opponent cast Dissolve on Cartel Aristocrat here. All right, actually, I'm not gonna play the Imposing Sovereign. I don't think I'd want to do that. Attacking clear doesn't do much. Let's flicker out the Obsidet. And if my opponent makes me sacrifice creature, I'm gonna sacrifice an Imposing Sovereign. Really, is my opponent casting a Revelation for two? All right, I would, be very happy, or rather, I am very happy since it doesn't seem like awesomeness. I guess if my opponent knows the top card, let's see, just make sure. All right, yeah, if you know your top card and it's another Revelation, I could see doing that, but burning a Rev for two when you're not actually under that much pressure, I can't really attack for a ton. I can start sacking things to deal two damage with Cartel Aristocrat. Second Blood Baron, that is kind of a beating. All right, need to draw Far Away here. Let's put Obsidot back in. Draw Far Away. No. Draw. Soldier of the Pantheon at least gets to attack. Let's play a Whip. And play a Temple, see what we're drawing. Soldier of the Pantheon. Yeah, let's put that on top, and then let's sack Imposing Sovereign to to give Tell Aristocrat protection from white, and attack to drain my opponent for two. I think that's worth it because I get a zombie back, and it drains my opponent for two, so I'm not really giving up much, and I can now whip and sack it. Let's see, unfortunately, whip, getting back a human sacking, doesn't get more necromancer tokens. That would be cool. So opponent's got dissolve and X in hand. All right, can't block clearly. Get to attack back for not a ton of damage. Draw. I like the second Zathar Necromancer. It's probably going to get countered here, but I think that's actually all right. I have a Whip of Erebos. At some point, I can bring it back. I probably didn't want to tap all my white since I would want to play a white creature here. If it does resolve, I get to. Alright, let's. Actually, let's just not do anything else. Let's just attack and attack with Cartel Aristocrat, and let's just sack the zombie token to give it pro white again. I do have to make sure that Blood Barons never get large and flying, because that would be very annoying. Alright. So, I'm bashing for four here. Rats get real bad. And then I'm playing another Soldier of the Pantheon. Devour Flesh still not looking great over there. And let's go ahead and get this out of here. Alright. As long as it's not casting Revelation, I'm not too unhappy. Azorius Charm. I don't get to gain two life, so that is worth it. Alright. And let's get you out of here. Oops it out. So if I get Devour Flesh, I guess I just sack a Soldier of the Pantheon. I don't think I want to sack Zathar Necromancer at this point. Feeling all right here. I'm not feeling great. I mean, my opponent's got a lot of stuff going, mostly because Baron plus a Dissolve in hand is kind of tricky. I've got to do a lot of maneuvering here. I am hitting for a good amount of damage a turn. 6 to 8 a turn, depending on what I want to sack to Cartel Aristocrat here. Draw. Wouldn't mind drawing something sweet. Yep, Sky Knight, not really what I'm looking for. Let's just play Imposing Sovereign here. If that's getting dissolved, I know, getting Soldier of the Pantheon, getting Doomblade. All right, let's sack it to Cartel Aristocrat then, I suppose. And then I'm getting Devour Fleshed. I do want to keep the Soldier. Do I want to keep both Zathar Necromancers? Actually kind of do, so I'm going to just sack Cartel Aristocrat. Just going to get a million soldiers here. Irrelevant protection, doesn't resolve, resolves. Alright, and let's whip back a... No, let's not whip back Cartel Aristocrat yet. Let's whip back a Soldier of the Pantheon, I think. No, actually, you know, I'd rather just play Leo Sky Knight. Even though I'm not going to do anything with it this turn, at least having it in play is good, especially with the two Zathar Necromancers. Opponents on Dissolve and X. Alright, and I guess I'll attack with Soldier of the Pantheon. Alrighty, so... Ooh, X is an Azorius Charm, which I only get one life for now. Opponent has that on lockdown. So now what's the plan? Can I attack with a million zombies yet? Yeah, I actually can. I can attack with basically everything but the Necromancers once I whip back Cartel Aristocrat. So, actually maybe I should have just left Cartel Aristocrat in play, but I really want both zombies in play. And I like Soldier of the Pantheon, so it's hard to tell. Draw something awesome. Let's play this first. Could draw Mutavault, but I'd still rather do this. Glare of Heresy. I think I actually put that in the bottom just because it doesn't do anything for me right now. Ooh, Underworld Connections does, though. So my opponent's got Dissolve in hand. Let's just wait on that. So if I get back Cartel Aristocrat, Blood Baron blocks... I guess I don't want it to attack with Ghost Council. I don't attack with Ghost Council. Blood Baron blocks Imposing Sovereign or a zombie token, either one. Yeah, that's fine, I think. Though I guess I could maybe start attack with Ghost Council, start sacking it. I'm not going to do that yet, but that's something to consider in the future here. Actually, if I attack with everything, what happens if... Then you have to block Obsidian and you take 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 21. It's on dissolve and something. Actually, that seems fine, because I can just sack. So you block cartel risk, go to 22, and you take 8. Yeah, that's a lot of damage. All right. Of course, my opponent has Sphinx's Revelation here. This could be kind of disastrous, but if not, then I like where we're going here. All right, so let's sack that to Cartel Aristocrat. Then even if my opponent removes all of that, do 2, 5, 15, 19. All right. Though, clearly Revelation is not good for me. Oh, Hero's Downfall on the Cartel Aristocrat. Okay, that's not the one you want to kill. All right. Strange. So let's see if... Let's just take a look. My opponent... Yeah, I can't hit okay or I, you know, this goes away. All right. Let's say my opponent kills Obsidat here. Then I'm doing 2, 5, 7, 4 zombies is 15, 17. Yeah, it's going to be hard for my opponent to win off that position, I think. But... All right, Esper Humans, we got there. Let's go ahead and look at Deck Builder real quick since not quite done yet. I like the way it played because Zath the Necromancer is really good, and actually Leof's Gun, it's quite strong also. I think you'd want to tighten up the 2-drops here. I didn't like Imposing Sovereign, and I don't love Darren Skyjack. I'd almost want more Cartel Aristocrats, and I guess maybe you have to play like Skyjack at that point just to have the right human count. But I don't love the Sovereigns here. Didn't feel like that was the kind of game you wanted. And Whip's okay, but I don't know if 2 is what you want. I do like the sideboard. Piano Heed seems a little random. Well, again, I'm probably missing like some insane interaction with it. And I'm not sure if I love like the random Blood Baron and the mix of removal spells in the sideboard I would want to figure out. But well, for the most part, the deck did seem pretty sweet. So I'm probably going to play a little more with it just to try to figure that out.